Hello, hello. Welcome to my next tutorial. This is probably something that's going to be really useful at least for a while for a lot of people, up until the creation kit for Fallout 4 comes out. Let's adjust the music. There we go. We're going to be using Fallout 4 Edit. I already recorded this tutorial earlier, but then I was made aware that there are restrictions in Fallout form lists when crafting and creating different crafting categories, and that you should always be using the community resource for armor and weapon crafting. So I'm going to show you that first. Easiest way is to get it to it through my is this armor and weapon keywords community resource. So before you start, get this because we are going to be using it as a base for this tutorial. We're gonna be building our armor mod that is sort of slaved or linked to this resource. It's gonna make life hell of a lot easier, and in the future when we have tons and tons of armor mods and they're all gonna be using the same resource, so they'll be the most compatible. Imagine you have four different armor mods and each of them adds a new crafting menu under chemistry station and says outfits. The user is gonna have four outfits menus and he's gonna have to figure out where to go for which armor. That's not gonna work, not in the long run. So this resource here comes in and makes our life easier. Now that you have installed that, we can get started on making new armors. First, we probably need to get Fallout 4 edit in the right monitor. You'll be wanting before we started, I made my Fallout folders completely clean, so I've pretty much got nothing but armor keywords, my resources for the armors, and that's it. Let's get this on the right. So load only Fallout 4 ESM and armor keywords into the XEdit. I'm gonna say X edit because it's gonna be a pain in the ass to say Fallout 4 edit all the time. So when I say X edit, I mean Fallout 4 edit. What you can see in the armor keywords ESM is that it has a lot of keywords. These are different kind of classifications for armor types, sort of like classes, what they're in. Let's sort it by editor ID. These CM means crafting menu, I assume. These are the recipes that you'll link. When you make recipes for your armor, you link to these different kinds of categories. These are preset, and you'll probably find something you'll like. These first two are which crafting bench it's gonna use. It's gonna be, well, we're gonna be using the armorsmith one. And then there are different kinds of classifications you can use, like if you want to tell the game that you're making a military class armor, or if you want a vault suit type, if you're making a sleuty vault suit or a utility jumpsuit like I did. And then if you're making different kinds of armor pieces or accessories, there's also classes for those as well. It introduces two different kinds of workbenches. Let's go to show you the meshes, they look pretty awesome. Loads a while because it's tons of items. So this is the how would you not want this to be your crafting workbench? I mean, this is the most awesome fucking thing I've seen. So yeah, that's what we're gonna be using, that workbench. And the user will have to, when the player gets your mod, they will have to craft it in the build mode for themselves. It's gonna be coming to their game through armor keywords. And now that we have sort of what we need, why did I go from that we need? I need to show you what you need. So you've got your armor set up and you have nothing, no idea how to get it in the game. For a basic armor you need five things. You need the world model. This is what falls off when the player drops the item from their inventory, and what shows up when they're crafting or watching it, checking it out in their people menu. You need female and male versions. Let's hope I have all the textures. No, I don't. I don't have all the textures, but I don't have time to do that now. You need the first person model. This will show when the player is not in third person, so you'll need that. For a sleeveless outfit, I'm getting away easy because it's just the hands. I copied it. It's a vanilla arms. And then you need the female one. And the female armor should work. Yeah, so we'll be adding this to the game. Now we want this to be able to be worn with armor pieces, so I'm gonna start off by copying an existing armor from Fallout 4 ESM that I know can be used with armor pieces. My favorite one to copy is AA Clothes Synth Uniform. If I can ever find it. You don't want to copy the one for synths because that would be only wearable by the synth race. So you'll want this one. It's got the right pipe flags for us, and then we're gonna be changing all the file paths. This is like how you tell the game where the models are, how to display the armor. So we're gonna right click, copy as new record into. It's gonna ask you if you're sure, and yes, we are sure. Now give it a descriptive name. And remember, when you're copying this armor add-on, put the AA there. Now you can just make, like, it's easy to remember that it's the armor add-on, sort of like the skin. And now we are going to check new file. The ESP is going to be called this. You can call it whatever, my mod, my armor mod, but try to give everything descriptive names. It's going to help you on the long run. It wants us to slave this to Fallout 4 ESM, which is every mod is slaved to that. Next up we have armor copying. Now this is the actual armor object in the game, and you can sort by name, so you'll find, you know, it's synth uniform, so you can go to S and find it. How many S items can there be? There we go. You want to copy this, and again, do not copy the one for synths. Copy as new record into early Urban Ranger armor. Now I'm leaving out the AA, but this will help me because they have exactly the same names. It's going to be easy to look at them later. And now we're going to select our ESP that was created earlier. You can press space when it's selected if you want, and enter or click OK. I like using keyboard commands for everything. Now the last thing we want is a recipe because we want to be able to craft this thing. So you go to constructible object, find something that looks like armor crafting, like mod armors. I like to use the leather ones because then they have already. What does it use? Lead, adhesive, leather, yeah, something like that. So as you can see, the components here on the right. So we don't have to add them all one by one later if we already copy one. Where is leather armors though? And copy as new record into Ellie recipe Urban Ranger armor. Again, descriptive name links it directly to the armor, so it's easy to find and link. Now we have everything we need from Fallout 4 ESM. As you can see, this one has appeared here, and it's bold. Bold means something has changed. You've made edits to the item. Now we want to link it to the armor keywords ESM. It's got everything here. Select the ESP name. Choose Add Masters. it will offer you to add this ESM there. You can press space or tick it with the mouse. And press OK. Now you can check that it actually did add it from the file header. File header lists all the master files for your ESP. And the AMA keywords is here. Now this, what this does is enables us to use all these keywords and recipes from, well, we don't need the recipes from here, but it allows us to use all these keywords from here, which is the main focus of what the point of the AMA keywords is. Now we're going to be linking this armor add-on to all the models for our armor. I usually prefer copy-pasting file parts from here. So the first one is the male world, the male model, which was the one I didn't have textures for. So it's this one. Sorry about it looking all weirdy. I forgot to copy all necessary ones. Now copy that, put it here. Sorry about my cat, she's a pain in the ass. Copy this up until meshes. Now you can either choose edit and we'll open this edit value window, or you can press F2 and just copy paste it here. Ctrl C, Ctrl V is your friend. Now it will ask us for the female model. Female model was this one. Come on, there we go. Paste it there, now we get the full path. F2, Ctrl V. Now I talked about the first person model, which was just the arms. First the male one. There we go. And the last one is the female first person. You don't have to, because this is a simple clothing item that we're just gonna place armor pieces on. You only need these two. Don't edit that one. And that should be all for this one. Don't worry about the races. This is just like additional creatures, races that can wear it. By default, it's for human race, but also ghouls and synths can wear it. Now that we have our armor linked to the models, you can select here, highlight it, press F2. That gets you the form ID, which you're going to be needing in the next step. It's called Urban Ranger Armor, so I'm going to give it a name here. This is the name that will show in player's inventory. Here you can choose which kind of object effect it has. Does it fortify perception? If you press F2 here, it will show up this little arrow, and you can choose from all kinds of armor enchantments, so-called enchantment effects, buffs, all kinds. If you want, you can also scroll up a bit and you can find legendary ones. I wouldn't recommend it using something that's meant for weapons, but here are the armor legendaries. For example, if you want to put low health slow time on it, we can do that. So now when the player is under 20% health, it will slow time just like all the martyr pieces that you find in-game. Now we're gonna need to link it to the world model so that it doesn't look like synth uniform when you drop it from your inventory. So we're gonna copy this one. F2, Ctrl V. Our armor looks a bit like, let's see if we can find anything. I'm just gonna leave that. I've never changed it, never touched it. I don't quite know what it does, but you don't need to touch that. Now this is an important part. As you can see, that it's got two links to the armor add-on. Copy this again because I copy pasted. If you were if you did have a different model for synths, you would need to link these both. Like if you were in Skyrim and you had a hood that had different models for Khajiit or Argonians, this would be the same thing. Like additional races can wear this armor, but they have their unique model. We don't need this, however, because there's no different synth model. You can select here where it says armature and press delete. It will remove it. This is the link. Now we want the Urban Ranger armor AA here. As I copy pasted the form ID, I can just click edit and paste it here. And now they're linked. Now what you want to add are a bunch of keywords. These keywords control where in what kind of armor add-ons you can put on it, like if you can upgrade it with the ballistic weave. And this is where we're gonna need the armor keywords, ESM. When we select here, we can see that we have, yeah, these are the ones with the underscore are from armor keywords, ESM. So this is clothing, I suppose, or we could call it armor. But I don't know if this armor means like armor pieces, like leather shoulders or combat armor pieces. I'm just gonna say clothing. That's what I've been putting on my full body armors. Add a new one. This is a vanilla one. Need to link it to the railroad clothing armor list so that the game knows this is one of those armor types you can put Vive on. INRD, add a new one to that. It's DN codes, another one you need for the ballistic weave. And you need APPR, add, click here and add. AP Railroad Clothing Armor No Weave. So now we have all the keywords we need for making this craftable with ballistic weave or upgradable. You can also add a bunch of stuff from if you want to classify the armor a bit further, like underscore. So we find the ones from armor keywords. If it's like if you're making a tuxedo, you could classify it as dapper. Or if you're making an institute uniform, you can classify it as that. If you have some sort of a military outfit, you can put these on it. Later, when there are like sorting mods, these will come in handy. If there's a sorting mod, sorts out armors in the player's inventory. These are what it's going to be using. So, be as precise as you can. Mine is not really military or casual, so I'm just going to leave it out. It's not skimpy either. So I'm going to take this off. If you have one that you don't want, select it and press delete. Okay, the last bit that we need is the actual recipe for it, so that the player can craft it at the Armorsmith workbench. You're going to want the components. Let's pour a bit more, like 6 leather and 12 cloth. Adhesive sounds good, 4, and then because it has... Holy crap, let's go back. Halt, back. I didn't put any armor rating on it. So put the basic damage resistance to 10 because it's not really a very buff armor or anything. You can also add resistances for additional damage like radiation. DT energy for 5 and add new. DT radiation exposure 5. So now it's sort of a light armor. It has a bit of an armor rating, but not too much. So now we can go to craft it. Take the conditions off. Let's add ballistic on it so that it actually has armor. See, this is confusing. It's anti-ballistic weave, or ballistic fiber. not ballistic fiber, I don't know why, but let's put 5 of them. So these are all the components, and now we need to tell the recipe what to craft. Currently there's some sort of a leather mod. Now we don't want, do not link it to the AA. It will not show up at the workbench. You need the actual armor object. Again, press F2 when this is selected, highlighted, and copy this one. Now you can just click edit here, paste it, and now this recipe will craft the Urban Ranger armor. But it's not doing anything yet because we haven't specified which workbench to use. You can either press F2 and browse through, well, first you need to add it, F2 and browse through all these keywords, or you can go to the armor keywords ESM, find the keyword for armor smith crafting key. When this is selected, F2, get the form ID, go to the recipe, edit, paste it here. Now it's linked to the armor smith workbench. We also want to specify which category it's using, so we can copy from here as well. They're all listed here. Pick one that matches with what you want to craft. I suppose we're crafting an armor. So when this is selected and highlighted, again F2, you got it. Now you can go here, add a new keyword, edit, paste. You can press Ctrl S here and save your armor. Now, what if you want to make it a bit harder for the player to craft this armor? Currently there's no conditions, they can just walk up to the workbench and craft it. But you can add new ones. Let's say you want them to have the armorer perk, so they can only craft this if they have that perk. Sorry, coffee break. You'll want equal to 1, which means it's the same as true. If it was 0, equal to false. The function you want is has perk. You can just start typing when you have this selected. Has perk, enter. Make sure it gets the right one. Sometimes it doesn't, it picks something else from the highlighted list. So make sure you have the right function. And now we need the perk. Again, when you have this highlighted, you can just start typing. Armorer is the perk. Let's say we need to have the second level of it. I think that's all you need. You could also add that the recipe doesn't show up in the player's crafting menu unless they have something, unless they have all the ingredients. This helps if you have tons and tons of armor mods all crafted in the same location, adding more conditions to them so that they don't show up at all. Is helpful. Add greater than, you can start typing and select greater than from here. So greater than 0, they have more than 0, from 1 to gazillion. Get has upper. What the heck? Get item count, please. Yes, there we go. Sorry. My derp. And the item is ballistic fiber. It won't show up if they don't, unless they have. And try ballistic fiber. Oh, it doesn't let you select components. I didn't know that. What else could we use? So it wants you to give it misc item, which are like loose items. You can add your own one if you want. Like, let's see, I have one. I'll show you. Crafty skull. This is a small item that I just... it's a skull I added glasses to. We put it to the meshes folder. Now let's find skull here. The fact that it wouldn't let me select components threw me off. Now I'm all confused. Come on, there can't be that many S items. There we go, skull. Again, copy as new record into Ellie Crafty Skull. Put it to the Urban Ranger armor. Whatever you do, don't edit armor keywords CSM. It's meant to be the same for everyone. The player is not gonna download it from Nexus. Do not pack it with your mod. Okay, now you can see that we copied it, but it didn't show up here. What you need to do is just close this and open it, and it will have appeared. Give it a new name. Crafty Skull. Now the player needs to have this in their inventory if they want to be able to craft this. You can make it so that it's a book, for example. Use the pre-war book model, and then put it for to a merchant inventory so that they are selling it in Time City Surplus or wherever. Put the file path here. Now if you want it to be scrappable, leave the components here. Like, this means how much they're gonna receive from scrapping it. If you want it to appear in the MISC section instead of junk, just remove all components. Now it's a MISC object. I'm gonna save. Go here. Now the player has to have Ellie Crafty Skull. Oh crap, it won't show up unless I restart. So I saved my thing and I'm gonna restart Fallout 4 edit. Because else the MISC skull doesn't seem to appear. Go to constructible object. You can just copy this from here. Paste it. Yes, I'm sure. There we go. And run on subject. Well, the one we're checking. Now I hope that's it. We're gonna activate this and go see it in game. Alright, so here we are in game. Let's take that atrocious doff off. Since we didn't put anything here how to get the crafty skull, I'm just gonna add it with the console. I'm gonna drop it here. Now we're gonna need the armorsmith workbench and craft it. This is my test save, it doesn't really... That's why there's people naked, because they've lost their armors. That is a gorgeous thing, that's the best looking workbench ever. Okay, so we have that. And when we look at it, we don't have any recipes available. But when we pick up the skull... Kate, shut the fuck up! Now that we have the skull in our inventory, the recipe shows up. Naked MacReady. Let's craft the armor. And let's see what happens when you put it on. Dun 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 dun. And it works. That's why my character looked weird, because this is a CBBE model and I had to install CBBE textures on a vanilla body. So yeah, the thing works fine. MacReady, mind modeling this for us? I went and picked up the correct textures, so now it turns up. You are looking dashing. Yes. So that's how you add armors and conditions and crafting recipes. And do remember to use armor keywords. ESM, because that just makes life easier for everyone, especially the mod user. You're making the mod for the user, right? Well, I'll see you in the next video. Leave comments if you have any questions or if I did something terribly wrong in your opinion. This is just how I've always done it. This will probably be obsolete once the creation kit comes out. But still, it'll serve us for the time being. And with that, we're gonna end this video.